My well, it's a paradise whenever I'm with you. Ride on.
You're unlikely to see any of these models on the front cover of Vogue or Vanity Fair.
It's long. Well, it's a mighty long road, but I'll find you, I will hold you, and I'll be there.
But make no mistake, all of the animals on the books of this Liverpool talent agency are professional models, and none of them are camera shy.
Ideally, they would like the cat to be off lead.
Okay.
But if, obviously, because it's outdoor...
It's all the brainchild of Layla Flaherty, herself a model and reality TV star.
So here we are in the Animal Talent and Casting Agency. Who knew there was such a thing? How did all of this come about?
Well, it all started from Buttons here, aka Mr. B. I wanted a job really where I wasn't leaving him at home all day. Okay. And an opportunity for him to mix with other dogs. Right. So I kind of thought, what can I do? I really wanted to work with animals. I came up with the brainwave of an animal talent and casting agency.
And 3 years since she launched the agency, Urban Paws UK has grown rapidly and now has 1,000 animals on its books and appearing in everything from car commercials to films.
So who have you placed animals with in terms of advertising?
Oh God, we've worked with worldwide companies. Samsung, Disney, IKEA, Bowdoin, Stella McCartney, like really big, big names. It's fun working with animals and, you know, I suppose not knowing what you're going to get asked for next.
And you have been involved with a very, very high profile client and campaign recently.
Oh yes, Harry Styles. Oh, and Gucci. Yes, that was really, that's probably our biggest one to date.
I love you, that's all I want to say, until I find a way.
We didn't know at the time who the client actually was, but they kept it top secret and, you know, we would ring to find out how everything went if we're not present on set. And she was referring to Harry all the time. So we thought, I wonder who Harry is. And she said, oh, Harry Styles. We were like, oh my God.
Of course, using animals in advertising is nothing new. But the growth of social media has created a whole new outlet for animal advertising. Images of pets posted on social media sites like Instagram and Facebook can attract tens of thousands of followers, making them very attractive to advertisers. At Urban Paws, they surf social media on the lookout for pets that could fit the bill.
So basically, this is if your dog or cat or any animal has a social media account and has lots of people following what they do.
Exactly. And the client or the brand will come to them and they will ask for example, that dog or cat or guinea pig or whatever it is to be photographed with the product. And then therefore their thousands or millions of followers will then see this product. And essentially it's advertisement. And they get paid obviously as well for that.
It's remarkable, isn't it, to think that your family pet can provide an income.
Yeah.
Okay, Paris, wait. Wait. Wait.
And when it comes to talent spotting, Janet Connolly's Dalmatians are just what the advertisers are looking for. Between them, Paris, Florence, Rome and Vienna have got over 14,000 followers on social media. And what started out as a hobby for owner Janet has become a potential money spinner.
How seriously do you take this?
I don't take it seriously at all.
Don't you?
I don't. If they're prepared to sit and pose, then I'm not quite happy with the picture. If they're not going to do it, then they're not going to do it. It's as simple as that. It's just for fun.
But you have the potential with these, I mean, they are picture perfect dogs. You have the potential to earn a considerable amount of money, don't you?
I do. And
would you have ever believed that? Because this is such a new phenomenon really, isn't it?
It is. And no, I'd never have believed it. But after Paris getting their photo shoot, which earned money, I was like, wow. Which was for a global pet premix. Massive company, they supply all of the globe, and Paris is now the face of that, so that was quite amazing.
And it's fascinating because Paris was chosen out of all of yours because Paris has fewer spots, which is interesting in a Dalmatian, isn't it?
It is, but that's because they wanted to be able to put the map of Europe on her neck so so they didn't want any black around the neck area.
Is there anything that you would draw the line at as an animal owner? Because we see pictures of dogs dressed up in hats and sunglasses and clothes, and sometimes they don't even look like a dog anymore.
What I tend to do is dress them up in Dalmatian-related products.
Okay.
And they are a massive hit.
Right.
And some of the pictures we do are really, really good. So I, each to their own. If people want to dress the dogs, I wouldn't dress mine constantly. Mm. It's just an every now and again thing.
But one dog owner in Liverpool has taken all of this to another level. Her Instagram account has over 30,000 followers, making Marley a social media superstar.
Hold. Hold.
Marley!
Aww. Good girl.
Roll over.
With that kind of following, it's perhaps not surprising to learn that Marley has starred in TV commercials and advertising campaigns.
You are good.
She's really clever, sometimes too clever. Sometimes she knows that you want her to do something, but it's up to her whether she wants to do it or not.
Is that a source of frustration, though, when you're trying to get the perfect shot?
Sometimes, but it's important to never kind of project that frustration on the dog, because we are just an animal, and it's just the same as if someone was asking me to do something that I didn't want to do repeatedly. You've got to be patient, and you've got to think, well, there's always another day. So, yeah.
In some of the pictures, she's dressed up.
Yeah.
She's wearing outfits.
Yes.
Do anybody ever get in touch with you and say, I don't approve of that, you know, it's a dog, it's not a toy, it's not an accessory?
No, never. I think it's because a lot of people understand that, well, I think it's because of her Instagram stories as well, where they see what she's doing throughout the day. I think a lot of people can see that it's literally 5 minutes for a picture, and that's not necessarily like what she's like all the time.
Yeah. Do you think she enjoys it?
Yeah, I think she does, actually. I think she really likes the attention. I think it's really good for her as well, because she can be quite shy around new people sometimes. And so I really like that she's always got new people coming up to her, and it gives her that practice, really, of knowing that it's okay, and sometimes give them treats to give her so that it kind of builds up her confidence as well.
What would you say to people who are watching this and think, oh, I've got a dog or a cat who's as good-looking as that? What?
I think that you've got to be into like photography, and you've got to be creative to make something like this work. And if you are, then I think go for it. But it's a lot more than just having a good looking animal. It's got to be well trained. You've got to have a passion for it. It's not a money spinner. Like, you don't make a lot of money out of it. Or we certainly don't. We turn down a lot more things than we take on. I don't want to put too much on my plate. So, yeah, we just kind of do what we actually genuinely like. And other than that, we're just taking pictures of her out and about, whatever we're doing.
And naturally, like all models, Marley does enjoy letting her hair down and doing what dogs do best.